Here's something different than what we normally work on. This is a 1990 Catalina 22 that was brought to us a month ago to upgrade and outfit for the owner who wants to use it for a cruise to the Bahamas. We added this removable sprit pole for a furling code zero, kind of a cross between a large Genoa and an asymmetric spinnaker. The pole is 30 inches overall and extends 22 inches forward of the bow roller. And it has two release pins holding it onto holes drilled through the bow roller. Just got one pin in there now. Have to source another one. And we put eyes on the sides of the hull to hold the whisker stays with pelican hooks on them, and then the bow eye holds the bobstay. I believe the Catalina 22 came with options of a swing keel, which is probably more common, or a standard deep keel, and then there's this wing keel, which is more shoal draft. I think it draws about 2.5 feet of water. The wing keel seems a good compromise choice and safer in big seas than a centerboard. Although I don't recommend going offshore in a boat of this type unless it's a short trip with a fair weather window. Here we added a through hull for the electric bilge pump outlet, and on the other side is a manual bilge pump outlet. Here's got a outboard bracket that I think he has an 8 or 9 horse outboard motor, but 6 horse would be sufficient with a 25 inch extra long shaft like the Tohatsu Sail Pro or similar. Here we added a couple of bow eyes or U-bolts for drogue attachment, one on each corner. And here's a new rudder that we installed. He's going to keep his old rudder as a spare backup rudder. And we drilled a 5/16 hole there to put a nylon bolt in as a device to allow the rudder to kick up if you hit something. And of course you don't want to forget to put in clips under these pintles, because otherwise the rudder's going to lift up and float away. And before the boat came here, it already had these extra drains, and there's flap valves in them for the cockpit footwell. Starting up on deck at the bow, the boat has a sunken anchor locker that is self-draining, and it has just enough space for a small fortress anchor in there. It's got a solar vent and a good size original Bomar hatch. Here we've added a couple of wiring connectors for the mast wires and the VHF cable. And here we replaced a broken lower shroud chain plate with these bow eye type U-bolts, except for the center one, which is the upper shroud, and that still looks in good shape. We also replaced the original low 18 inch high lifeline stanchions here with standard size 24 inch, because these can throw you overboard if you come up against them, because they come up to you below the knee. I had already had this Dyneema lifeline on here. We just adjusted it. Before the boat got here, the owner had already had this Dodger frame fabricated and installed, laces on here to the frame. Now we had the option of putting these winches and rope clutches for the halyards coming off the mast either on the side of this pop top, because this boat has a pop top that lifts up. I'll show you in a minute. So when you're anchored or at the marina, you can have headroom inside under that pop top area. But for sailing, there's not any space for the winch handle if you mount the winch and the rope clutch over here on the side. Otherwise you'd have to turn the handle in quarter turns, which wouldn't be practical. So we put them up on the pop top. Obviously you have to slack the lines off when you want to raise the pop top and you can't sail with it up. But it's probably not very seaworthy option to be sailing with the thing up anyway, so that shouldn't be a problem. Got starboard replacement for the drop boards. He's got a ST2000 tiller pilot, and that comes off, plugs in there. Down here next to it is just a standard 15 amp extension cord plug. Not the heavy-duty 30-amp marine plug. It's not needed. It just powers the battery charger. Small charger only. Back here, an access plate was put in, trying to access the upper rudder gudgeons. Turns out there are no nuts inside there, so it's just a cover plate. The factory must have had a bronze or stainless plate fiberglass into the transom that they tapped the bolts into. Below that are the extra drains installed to help the cockpit drain faster with one-way valves on them. Back here there's a solar panel arch that was already installed, and we just put two 50-watt panels on it. And cable clamps running the power cables down through the deck. So aside from the electric tiller pilot, he's got this sheet-to-tiller type rig for self-steering when sailing. And because small boats like this, it's not always practical to put a wind vane self-steering on a transom, and they're quite expensive. So this is a low-cost option. I haven't used one of these before. Apparently they're built in the UK. And they can be bought online. The jib sheet goes around the winch, which is on this pivoting mounting block here. And then I think there are some bungee cords that hold it in a certain position. And this arm that comes out has a tiller extension bar that goes into this tiller socket, and then as the different wind tensions on the sail from different courses as they change, this will pivot. Supposedly does a pretty good job. I'll put a link to more info on that in the video description. Here's the deck water fill fitting for a new flexible water tank that we installed in the area under the cockpit footwell. I don't know if there's any access hatch on these boats originally under the footwell. I think the owner probably bought this one, and so that opens up some access down there. We put in this Nauta brand French-made tank, which is supposedly 23.5 gallon. And we also put this yoga pad underneath the tank to protect it from chafe. And you can see these stringers fiberglassed in We put those in for added strength. This is a large flat section of the hull, so we stiffen that up. Over on this side is the gas can locker. On the starboard side is the original battery locker, but because the battery's heavy and this is prone to getting wet back here, we moved the batteries forward. Inside we've made a few modifications, but it's basically the standard layout for the most part. Coming in there's a cooler that has a step on top, which is a clever design, I think. Probably original. Over here we've added a Lagun table, which is adjustable, and it lifts off just by loosening these brackets here. Swings around to different positions. Can be like that. Here in the center, or out of your way here. And that also opens up some more counter space, if you need it, around this mini galley here and the sink. It's got an Arrigo 1500 single burner non-pressurized alcohol stove, which works good. These are the optional pot holders. It can be slid in and out. It's not gimbaled on this boat, so on a rough day he'll have to either hold the pot or wait till he gets anchored. We've taken out the hand pump at the sink, and we put in a foot pump down here and a new spout at the sink. Added some gear storage bags like that one there and here. It's just a happy coincidence that this tabletop he ordered fits the slots to make a continuous bunk on the port side. If you need it, you could put extra cushion down there. The pop top is secured by four latches like this, and it's got four of these arms that are hinged and they'll lift up, giving you standing headroom underneath. We've got a mess of wiring here that owners have just added to over the years. So at this point, the best thing is to just rip it all out and start over. The boat originally had a very small switch panel here with inadequate wiring going to it. And so we've added some circuits and put in a larger breaker panel. And here is a Raymarine plotter. An electric bilge pump switch with a 12-volt outlet next to it. Below it is the solar charge controller, the digital display. And up here we have a Victron battery monitor gauge, which will tell you the battery voltage, amps coming in from solar and out through the accessories, and cumulative state of charge of the batteries. Here we've got a battery disconnect switch and an inverter disconnect switch. This is a 1,000-watt pure sine wave inverter to bring 12-volt DC up to 110 AC. And behind it, a 5-amp battery charger and the manual bilge pump. Up here, you can see we put in all the new wiring. So the Raymarine plotter is on this swing-out bracket, so it can be viewed from the cockpit or inside. Gotten out of the way. Here we've got a Group 31 Duracell AGM battery. I think it's 105 amp hours. Boat has one on each side. Secured well in there, tied down. And there's the shunt in the back for the Victron battery monitor. And then this is a bus bar for fusing and connecting the positive cables. Hinges and barrel bolts secure all these locker lids. And under the aft port settee and behind it is the second AGM battery. A great feature of AGM compared to standard flooded lead acid is that you can install them on their side because there's nothing to leak out, and they also don't need a special battery box as long as they're tied down good. Behind here, huge storage area, and we've got some eye straps installed so that he can lash down his spare rudder and tiller. And under this seat, another large storage area. Now, originally, there was no access here, so I had to drill some holes to get hoses and wiring running from aft to forward, because under the floor in the center is a very shallow bilge, but there's only a half inch clearance to get anything under through the stringers that go underneath this pan liner everywhere. And that's the electric bilge pump outlet, goes up to a vented loop, so it prevents back flooding. The settee side can also be set up with a backrest cushion, or it can be taken down and laid flat for extending the bunk here. We installed a standard Horizon VHF and AIS receiver. Behind it, there's another 12-volt outlet and the outboard motor disconnect switch for electric start and alternator. The starboard bunk has a lee cloth we installed with three snap hooks. Normally it just unhooks and stows under the bed. And if you want to get in and out of the bunk, you just disconnect the aft hook and you can climb in and out that way without all your gear falling out. You can see how shallow the bilge is here. It's only a couple inches deep. That gray hose is connected for the manual bilge pump pickup. And the white hose goes forward to the electric pump. Under the forward end of the settee, we've got the foot pump there, the float switch for the bilge pump, and the bilge pump just barely fit down in that tiny bilge. Here's where all the wiring had to come out. There's a inside mounted depth sounder transducer, Airmar, that has antifreeze in it. Doesn't require a hole through the hull. His original transducer through the hull is installed there, and we put in a 3/4 inch seacock to drain the sink. And then there's a household type water filter. We have a lift out plastic trash can that goes in that locker, which is kind of convenient. The owner had already had installed this inside aluminum pipe reinforcement bar that connects these bulkheads at the chain plate detachments to the mass compression post. Supposedly that's going to stiffen up the whole structure. We added a louvered door here to access that locker. Up forward, we removed the porta potty that was in here because it's kind of a mess and you have to carry water around inside of it and waste water, and it can stink and just be troublesome. Replaced it with just a simple toilet bucket. It's got a seat on it and a lid. This one's called the Lugabaloo. Anyway, you just put a plastic bag inside when you want to use it, if you need to dispose of the waste on shore later. And after a single use or one day, you can tie the bag up and replace it with another one. They sell a box of 100 of these bags pretty cheap. I think they're sold as bedpan liners and for hospitals. Also have the option of this called Eco Gel. It'll gel up if you have urine in there and you don't want to have that sloshing around or maybe get a leak in the bag. So it's got these individual packets, and you can dump that in there and it'll supposedly solidify the urine and deodorize it until you get a chance to close up the bag, and then you can dispose of it on shore later. Otherwise, offshore, you can forget about the bag, just put a little water in the bucket, use it, and dump it overboard. This is the kind of system that is commonly used on lightweight racing sailboats, and it's not the best solution for long-term liveaboard, but probably better than a porta potty, and for short-term use seems ideal. Very lightweight, simple, and cheap. You just put three wood blocks curved around the base to hold it, and the top is held in with a snap-on clip with a rope going around the upper part of the bucket. And behind Lovable Lou is another good storage locker. Up here on both sides of the hull in the V-berth, there are these leak cloths that have been repurposed for storage and also for radar reflectivity, because we've got copper foil inside of it. There's bungee cords at the top. You pull it out to store gear behind it, like bedding or life jackets or other lightweight items. And there's a large locker here under this bunk cover boards. Somebody's already started modifying this locker. It's got a fiberglass pan liner throughout the interior, and it's got a lot of hidden space. So behind here is several inches of dead space, inaccessible. And so they've already cut out some of that liner, and I think we're going to cut more of it out and add some strengthening in here with stringers and bulkhead where needed, and to make that locker big and accessible. And the top of the locker is about 7 inches above the waterline, so we could make these watertight lockers for collision protection. We've got the bulkheads cut out and ready to put in new ones. Now we've got this all fiberglassed in with new bulkheads and stringers along the hull to stiffen it up. This is a watertight locker now. It's been sealed all the way up to the top. And the small forward locker is also sealed, and this one's got a rubber gasket under the lid, so that can be latched down for collision bulkhead protection. And here's a 12-volt clip-on fan that can be moved around as needed inside the boat